ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى العظيم الحليم الكريم أن يغفر لنا ذنوبنا وأن يتقبل منا صالح أعمالنا وأن يجعلنا من المغفور لهم بعد الخروج من هذا المجلس، مجلس العلم. يا إخوة، معاذ بن جبل رضي الله عنه، when he was dying, يعني سبحان الله, he was amongst the companions who died in the epidemic of عمواس الطاعون. He said, I'm going to miss one of the things that I will miss in the dunya is this majlis. Subhanallah, للمجلس هذا بركة. Even if the person who is teaching is not up to your standard or you don't consider him to be, but subhanallah, المجلس هذا بركة. للمجلس بركة. مجلس ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى. This gathering has a blessing. يعني يكفيك حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن لله ملائكة طوافون. الله سبحانه وتعالى has angels who travel around earth and they are looking for this gathering. They are triggered by this gathering and they will come and they will circle us and then they will go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah knows what they are saying. Ya Rab, they are talking about you. هل رأوني? Have they seen me? And Allah knows. لا يا رب, ماذا لو رأوني? They are asking you the Jannah. هل رأوها? Have they seen the Jannah? No. What will they say if they would have seen the Jannah? They are seeking refuge with you from hell. هل رأوها? Have they seen hell? No. What would they say if they would have seen it? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, bear witness that they are all forgiven. أشهدكم أني قد غفرت لهم. Then the angels will say, but ya Rab, there was someone who is not really there for the majlis. He was not there for the gathering. Someone owed him money in the crowd and he was waiting for him by the door. Yani, that's one scenario. تقول الملائكة هم القوم لا يشقى بهم جليسهم. Even this person will be forgiven. فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يغفر ذنوبنا. Especially tonight. اختارك الله سبحانه وتعالى أن تكون هنا. Can you imagine how many Muslims chose to be where? Right now, as we speak, or planning to be where? Here you are coming to this place. يعني نتأول الحديث العبادة في الهرج. العبادة في الهرج. يعني المعنى الأول لكلمة الهرج القتل. But one of the explanation of the word الهرج
when everyone is disobeying Allah, when the disobedience is so easy, no one is going to prevent you if you want to go to the club. No one is going to take your hand. You can actually hide, get on a cab, and in the morning come and pray Fajr with the congregation. You can do that. So al-ibadatu fil harj, that you choose to be here in spite of having the options to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wal hadith sahih Imam Muslim, kahijra ilay, as if you migrated to the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يرزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل في السر والعلن وأن يعلمنا ما ينفعنا وأن ينفعنا بما علمنا وأن يزدنا علما. جزاكم الله خيرا for attending and being here tonight. The subject was suggested by a group of brothers and I'm going to make it as brief, as sweet, as dandy as possible. But it's really a subject for students of knowledge. يعني it requires some focus a little bit. The subject is حسن الخلق, good characters. يا إخوة ما أحوجنا في هذا الزمان لهذا الموضوع. How much we are desperate as an ummah for this subject. You may find brothers who do not even let go one jama'ah, but yet the character is not there. Having a good character is a key. I want to introduce you to the subject with a very interesting kind of academic introduction. Bear with me, and then it's going to go easy after this. Pay attention to this. The scholars from the first three braised generations. Who are the first three braised generations? The Sahaba, then Tabi'in, then. When they want to author books, literature, إذا أرادوا أن يفردون كتبا في الخلق, addressing the subject of al-akhlaq, they always make it part of the aqeedah. You see, the religion of Islam, there is the belief system, which we call aqeedah. Then there is the ibadat, the salah, the zakah, fiqh al-ibadat, how to pray, how to fast. That's one branch. And there is the transactions, al-mu'amalat. Then al-akhlaq, character. Then there is tafsir, usul al-fiqh, multiple branches. Hadith, ilm al-hadith. Now, when they want to author books on the subject of al-akhlaq, they make it part of al-aqidah. They don't separate it from al-mu'taqad, al-aqidah. Why? I'll share with you three reasons. Reason number one, because this is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself did. He never separated the aqeedah from the akhlaq. طيب, what is my evidence? Hadith Abi Hurairah, that's one, radiyallahu an, في البخاري. Look at this. من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر. Whoever believes in Allah and the hereafter. What is this? Aqeedah or what? Isn't the aqeedah believe in Allah and the hereafter? What is the aqeedah? Believe in Allah, angels, messengers, books, the day of judgment and qadr. هذا هو العقيدة. So whoever believes in Allah and the hereafter, فليكرم ضيفه. Let him be what? Generous to his guest. خلق ولا مش خلق? Being generous is خلق ولا لا? So خلق is what? Connected to what? من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فلا يؤذي جاره. If you believe in Allah and the hereafter, عقيدة. Don't inflict harm upon your neighbor. خلق ولا مش خلق. من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو. You see the connection? والحديث المشهور اللي تعرفونه يا إخوة, الإيمان بضع وستون شعبة إيمان faith is 60 plus branches وفي لفظ 70 plus branches أعلاها the highest branch of الإيمان is what لا إله إلا الله is عقيدة what عقيدة ولا لا طب وأدناها and the lowest is what removing harmful object from the street look look والحياء isn't الحياء خلق والحياء what is الحياء modesty شعبة من شعب الإيمان you see the connection they are one why يا إخوة why are we saying this because nowadays you will find Muslims uttering that statement and they think يحسبونها هينة وهي عند الله عظيمة يقول لك إيه أنا أخي بعامل النصراني واليهودي بلاقيه أحسن من المسلم when I deal with a Christian or a Jew I find them what in dealing you're right maybe the Muslim is not having a good character but you can't give preference to the other one هذا رجل حاد الله وحاد رسولك this one at least he says لا إله إلا الله عنده اعتقاد عنده belief he believes in Allah he believes in your messenger just help him to become a good person but you shouldn't be making that statement add to this brothers and sisters in Islam we may find a lot of people who do not have the proper beliefs have a good character and we get confused and if you want to know something and I was sharing this with my brothers earlier there is a character when you have a lot of the people are willing to overlook your bad characters because of that character you know what character في خلق لو عندك الناس تتغاضى عن الأخلاق السيئة اللي عندك what character generosity الكرم الإنسان الكريم the people love him the giver and they are willing to overlook his طب look at this man عائشة في صحيح الإمام مسلم one day she asked the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم يا رسول الله ما يفعل الله بعبد الله بن جدعان What Allah will do with Abdullah ibn Jud'an? Abdullah ibn Jud'an, the ikhwa, he used to feed all the hajij. He was so generous that the pan of food was sufficient to feed everybody who comes to hajj. So Aisha is asking, Ya Rasulullah, this man was so generous. Will Allah give him something? You know what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to her? هو من أهل النار. He's a dweller of hell. Why? Why? لم يقل يوما رب اغفر لي خطيئتي يوم الدين. He doesn't believe in the hereafter. He never said one day, Oh Allah forgive my sins. طيب. When عدي بن حاتم, you know حاتم الطائي? You heard the name حاتم الطائي? يضرب به المثل في الكرم. If you want to use an example of generosity, it's like كرم حاتم. So when Adi, his son, came to accept Islam, so he looked at the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he said, يا رسول الله, ما يفعل الله بحاتم? He said, يا Adi, your father wanted something and he got it. What did he want? The name. He wanted to be famous of generosity. He got it. Here we are. Hundreds of years we're talking about his generosity. هو ما فعل هذا يبغي الآخرة. لا. يا إخوة, why do we say this? Because these days, especially the youth, يقول لك أنجلينا جولي وماما مش عارف تريسا ولا مش عارف ماما مين. اسمع المعتقد مثل الذين كفروا بربهم أعمالهم كرماد اشتدت به الريح في يوم عاصف. The likeness of the deeds, the good deeds of those who do not believe in Allah and the hereafter, believe in the messengers, they don't have the correct belief system. Their deeds are like ashes in a windy day, in the day of judgment. فمهم الربط بين المعتقد وبين الأخلاق. The second reason, brothers and sisters in Islam, and I kind of hinted to this a minute ago, and pay attention to this. You tell me what you believe in. You could have the most correct beliefs. But you know what? If you don't have a good character, it will not come out. People are not going to know about it. And I give you the example of the people who say Jews and Christians are better. Look, they got out their mu'taqad when they say they are very good in dealings. When they say Christian and Jews, they got their what? They got their mu'taqad out. لأن على الحقيقة يعني I want to tell you something. A non-Muslim doesn't see anything in you but your character. He careless whether you're fasting today or not. He careless whether you pray tahajjud at night or not. And I'm gonna come to the importance of ibadah here. I'm not belittling the ibadah, but in general, what a non-Muslim sees in you is your character. I'll give you a practical example. Abu Dharr al-Ghifari رضي الله عنه Jundub ibn Junada, that is his name. Of course, he used to live in a place called Ghifar, which is a distant place from Mecca. And Abu Dharr, ya ikhwa, one of the companions who used to worship Allah according to the millah of Ibrahim and Ismail. He never worshipped idols, one of the few companions. Never. مَا سَجَدَ لِصَنَمٍ فَهِ heard that I'm just conveying you the context of the statement here. He heard that there is somebody in Mecca claims to be a prophet. يعني in reference to Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He doesn't know. It's a claim. فهي had a brother whose name is أنيس. قال يا أنيس اذهب فأتني بخبر الرجل. Go and look at this man and tell me whether he's truly a messenger or a claimant. أنيس went to Mecca. Pay attention, Mecca. Not Medina, Mecca. You see, يا إخوة, good character when you're oppressed is a killer. And this is the message that we need to learn at the era of Islamophobia. There is a lot of Islamophobia. People don't like us. Imagine Donald Trump got elected. Anybody in his sound mind would not even expect this guy to go through the election. He was elected. Why? Why? Because of his message. Islamophobia. You know, very soon he's going to be in office and he's going to say, listen, guys, all that stuff is bogus. I was just kidding. You know, I got elected. You know, the problem is not, we're not going to see Trump anymore. He's going to be in the White House. But you know where is the alarming fact here? Over 50% of America believe in the stuff that he preached. They actually believe in it. That's Islamophobia, a lot of Islamophobia. And quite frankly, I want to tell you something. Islamophobia is not only amongst the non-Muslims. There is a lot of Islamophobia in the Muslim world, with the Muslim community. Oh, stay away from the Sheikh. Oh, this guy is fanatic. Stay away from him. So, there is a lot. Oh, yes. There is a lot of Islamophobia. The best way to deal with Islamophobia is good character. So I'm telling you, Unais went to the Prophet where? In Mecca. Mecca was the place where the Muslims were oppressed, persecuted. Unais spent some time there. He was like a surveillance camera. You know the surveillance camera? On the Prophet, watching. He went back to his brother and he submitted a report made of one sentence. You know what he said to his brother? رأيت رجلا يأمر بمكارم الأخلاق. I saw a man, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I saw a man who is commanding the best of characters. For sure, he saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praying around the Kaaba. That's what he sees in you. But this is the da'wah, ya ikhwa. Da'wah in action. Your credibility is in your character.
This is why, if you read the story of Yusuf carefully, when Yusuf jailed because of that rumor,
what was the rumor? The women, right? So somehow he's accused falsely of being engaged in immorality, basically. So when he interpreted that dream to his inmate, when he came and he asked him about the dream, he interpreted to him, the king said, "What? Go and bring him out to me. Release this guy." Basically, he received a presidential release from jail. What did he say? "Nope, I'm not coming out. I'm not going to come out. I'm a caller to Allah. You want me to come out when I have that allegation in my record? I'm a woman guy? No. ارجع إلى ربك فاسأله ما بال النسوة." Because I'm not going to come out for fun here. I want to call to Allah. I want to invite people to the way of Allah. Now, I shouldn't have this on my record. I want to clear my record from this. Extremely important, ya ikhwah. This is why when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was commanded in that chapter, Surah Al-Shu'ara, وَأَنذِرْ عَشِيرَتَكَ الْأَقْرَبِينَ, يقول ابن عباس, صعد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم جبل الصفا. He took the mountain of الصفا. And look at this now. Look at this. He asked the Qurayshi, "What if I tell you that there is an army behind this mountain coming to attack you? There is an army behind me right here, behind this mountain, coming to attack you. What will you say?" What did they say to him? Anybody knows what? "Ma ahidna alayka kathiba." We're going to believe you. Why? We never experience you lying. See, this is the da'wah. If we want to change the condition of the Muslims, I'm telling you, this is the way to go. Right here. It's a tough path. It's not an easy path. But this is the only way left for us. I'm telling you, the only way left for us. You know what? I'm going to share with you. It's not only the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A lot of you do not know that Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu actually tried to migrate from Mecca to Abyssinia. A lot of you do not know this. Like the rest, like Ja'far and the rest of the companions. So he gone to the Red Sea and about to get on a ship to go to Abyssinia to migrate. Who meets him there? A man by the name of Ibn al-Dighinna. Who's Ibn al-Dighinna? A leader of a tribe equals a president of a country at our time. Sayyid al-Qara, a tribe called al-Qara. They were very famous of archery. Look. إِلَىٰ أَيْنَ أَنْتَ ذَهِبَ. Where are you going, Abu Bakr? أنت راح فين? He said, "Man, I'm leaving your town, man. You guys are giving us a hard time. Our women cannot wear hijab. You stop us longer hours at the airport. We lose our jobs because we can't pray." He didn't say that, but that's Islamophobia. That's Islamophobia. It was Islamophobia. Islamophobia is not a new thing. Here is a non-Muslim telling a Muslim what? Look at this. You know what he said to him? Anyone knows what he said to him? مثلك لا يخرج ولا يخرج. Someone like you should not be expelled, or should he leave? Why? Why? We always use this hadith to show the people the similarity between the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. He mentioned the same exact things almost Khadija mentioned to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he returned from the cave, assuming that he was contacted by a jinni, not an angel. What did Khadija say to him? إنك تصل الرحم تحمل الكل تكسب المعدوم تعين على نوائب الحق. The same exact things. Again, what Ibn al-Dighinna stated? What? What? أخلاق خلق. If we want to invite to this deen, ya ikhwa, the خلق There is no other way.
But now, some of you may assume that we're belittling the ibadah. لا. من مقاصد العبادة تربية على الأخلاق.
One of the objectives of all the ibadat is to cultivate characters in us. Look,
الصلاة.
إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر.
بالله عليك, one of the biggest diseases that we all have is what? Pride, arrogance.
One of the, يعني you have to fight this one. النفس لها سلطان يا إخوة علينا. Always. النفس, يعني each one of us has that fear inside. But الحمد لله يعني إيه. Look, what is the best position in the salah? When can you be the closest ever to Allah in the salah? When you place what? The most honorable limb in your body. كلا لا تطعه واسجد واقترب وأقرب ما يكون العبد من ربه وهو ساجد. The closest you can be in the salah is when you're prostrating. That teaches humility. That teaches humbleness. Look at الزكاة. خذ من أموالهم صدقة. تطهرهم وتزكيهم. To purify their nafs from stinginess. يعني one of the service that زكاة and صدقة makes that you purify yourself from stinginess. Being stingy. That when you give and so forth. Look at Hajj. فمن فرض فيهن الحج. When you perform Hajj what? فلا رفث ولا فسوق ولا جدال في الحج. So the ibadah itself develops characters. Add to this, having a good character, ya ikhwa, is not easy. If you think it's easy, it's really difficult. And I'm going to come to this in a minute. You know what charges you to have a good character? Is the ibadah. For you to be patient, to be forbearing, العبادة helps you. Look at this. يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بإيه؟ و الصلاة is going to help you to be patient. الصبر is a character. الصلاة is what? عبادة. طب شوف هذه. شوف.
وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما.
عباد الرحمن, the slaves of Allah who walk in earth with humility, and when somebody infringes their rights, he addresses them in an ignorant way. They say what? They say what? سلاما. Why were they able to do this? The next verse explains. Why? What is the next verse? Because they stay up nights in salah. وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَمًا. That helped him to do the first one. شوف القرآن يا إخوة, من القرآن, if you really reflect upon it.
قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ.
And then what? لا لا لا, والذين هم عن اللغو معرضون. خشوع in salah will help you to do what? So I don't think that we're belittling the ibadat. Absolutely, the ibadat is the charging engine to have a good character. The objectives of the ibadah is certainly to develop a lot of the characters which فإذا كان يوم صوم أحدكم فلا يرفث ولا يفسق ولا يجهل وإن سابه أحد فليقل. One of the brothers was telling me right before the you know the, or back the culture where we're coming from, the brother would in Ramadan would get so angry. He's angry all the time. What's wrong with you, Akhi? I'm sorry, Akhi, I'm fasting. You're fasting? We're supposed to. So he's justifying his anger with what? لا, you're missing the point. لا, fasting develops what? Good character. The third reason. You guys are, did I lose you? You're still, I'm still explaining why our ancestors would author the subject of al-akhlaq in the area of al-mu'taqad. Why? We mentioned two reasons. The third reason, and this is a simple one, like your i'tiqad is consistent. You cannot question your i'tiqad. Your character also should be consistent. You don't have character one day and the next day you have another character. Sahib al-khuluq is always what? Is consistent.
I come to a second point quickly here. Is a lot of us make that statement.
يا أخي ربنا خلقني كده وما ربنا خلقني كده أنا متنرفز ربنا عملني كده Allah created me like this. How accurate that statement? It's a wrong statement. Why? Because they tell you الأخلاق نوعان. Characters are two types. One type you're born with. Some of us, subhanAllah, are born what? With certain. في بعض الإخوة كده تلاقيه حليم صبور. His صبر kills you. يقول لك إيه ده ما بتحركش يا راجل. إيه ده ما عندوش دم. Some of us will say that. يعني يضربون المثل بالأحنف بن قيس في الحلم. الأحنف بن قيس هذا يعني you curse him, you insult him. He doesn't do nothing. So a group of people got together and said, let's test this guy, man. Let us test this guy. So he's walking towards his tribe. So they followed him. Ya ibn مش عارف إيه, you're a son of this, you're a son of that. You are this, you are all type of insults that he can expect. He didn't even turn to them, he just walked. And then when he approached the entry to his tribe, he found a rock and he sat on the top of the rock and he looked at them. He said, what are you doing? He said, I just want you to finish the insults because if you follow me inside my tribesmen are going to come after you. So just finish insulting me and then I just don't want to. Imagine someone like this. Imagine. Can you beat someone like this? You can't. And normally, Ikhwa, you need to realize something. The people who try to get in your case, they want to see anger out of you. They want to get you angry. They want to get you upset. وَلِذَلِقْ قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ Look at this hadith. لَيْسَ الشَّدِيدُ بِالصُّرْعَةِ The strong person is not the one who yells loud. Is not the one who beats everyone down. No. ولكن الشديد but the real strength what من يملك نفسه عند الغضب is the one who controls himself when he gets angry. This is the true strength. But the other one, no. حتى in a gang language, you know the gang business. You guys know the gang. Come on, you know the gang. You know, in a gang language, they tell you the weakest person in the gang is the loudest. Wallahi, this is a term that they have. The weakest person is the loudest. But the guy who's doing like this, know that this is al-amir. هذا هو ال... Especially, we need this, يعني, subhanAllah. This is why Allah placed... We have sisters here tonight? Yes? Allah al-musta'an. This is why Allah placed the ismah in your hand. يعني, a lot of the brothers, wallahi, they come to us, mashayikh, especially if it is the third divorce. Yani he divorced his wife one time, revocable. Within the 3 months, he can take her back without contract, without nothing. Then he says the word divorce again. Within the 3 months, he can what? Take her back. Then he comes the third time, he does it, and then he comes crying to you. Yeah, Sheikh, she got me very upset. She got me angry. Brother, have you ever found somebody that he goes to his wife and tells her, I divorce you? You must be angry. You must somehow be angry. But who said that when you're angry, you divorce your wife? You have to be angry. Nobody is happy and then he goes, he divorces his wife. Nobody does this except somebody who's out of his mind. That's why Allah blessed the isba in your hand. Yeah, tell her. Another brother tells me, Sheikh, she's telling me, my wife told me, لو انت راجل طلقني. If you're a man, divorce me. Just if your wife tells you that. طب انت يقول لي خلاص I'm a man, you're divorced. Where is the man here? لا brother, inshallah I'm going to pray istikhara inshallah. I'll let you know inshallah. That's the time. That's the style. هذا هو some of us are born with this. That's what I'm trying to say. خلق فطري. ولو ان كلمة يعني ايه الفطرة هذه يعني you're fashioned with it. Allah placed it in you. And there are other characters that you have to do what? Practice it. What is the evidence for this? A famous hadith, يا إخوة في السنة, حديث وفد عبد القيس. The year of delegation, عام الوفود, اللي هو إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا. This year, a delegation came from Yemen, 40 of them, headed by a man. His title is Al-Ashaj, Ibn Abd al-Qais. You can imagine now that he's the head of that delegation, that everyone was looking forward to see and meet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So when they arrived Medina, the message of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they left their camels, their mules, and tied, and they rushed inside the masjid, and they sat in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Al-Ashaj, their leader, did not do this. He's the leader. He went around slowly. He tied all the camels. And he's taking his time. And after he finished, you know, he felt like that thawb that I came traveling in is not clean enough to sit with the Prophet with it. He changed it and he put another thawb. Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is watching him while he's sitting with his delegation. And he asked him, who's this man there? قالوا هذا سيدنا. This is our leader. This is the Amir of the delegation. So when he entered, Salamu alayka Rasulullah wa alaykum as-salam, immediately the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa looked at him and said, يا أشج فيك خصلتان يحبهما الله ورسوله. You have two characters, Allah and His Messenger do love. الحلم والأنا. Where is الحلم? Any leader would have come to the message, hey guys, get up! Tie your camels, everybody. لا, you let them, حلم. والأنا, that you're very patient. Look what he said. يا رسول الله, O Messenger of Allah, أجبلني الله عليهما. Did Allah create me with these two? قال نعم. قال الحمد لله الذي جبلني على ما يحب. All praise be to Allah who fashioned me the way that He wants me to be. Some of us have these, but most of the characters, يا إخوة, you have to work on it. ولذلك يعني الأثر يصح موقوف على عثمان. Look at this. إنما العلم بالتعلم والحلم بالتحلم. ربط العلم بالحلم. Why? We all agree that we came out of the womb of our mothers. What? والله أخرجكم من بطون أمهاتكم لا تعلمون شيئا. But he given us the senses. وجعل لكم السمع, that you can listen to a lecture. الأبصار, you can read a book. والأفئدة, so that you could reflect upon something. لعلكم تشكرون. So before knowledge, you did not know. إنما العلم بالتعلم. Likewise, خلقه والحلم بالتحلم. If you want to be for parent, you have to exercise for parents. طيب, in 10 minutes, and then we're going to let you ask questions and answer. What is حسن الخلق? What is that? What is this? يعني حسن الخلق. حسن الخلق made of two components. Number one, كف الأذى. Two, بذل الندى. So the first step to have a good character, كف أذاك عن الناس. Listen, if you cannot be smiley and proactive, and some of us don't have this, no problem. But what you have to do is what? Stop inflicting harm upon people. You can't be positively engaged in a good character meanwhile when there is a gossip group, you're out there gossiping. When there is a backbiting, you're backbiting. لا 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 لا. ولذلك قال صلى الله عليه وسلم المسلم, who's the Muslim? من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده. The true Muslim is the one the rest of the Muslims are protected from his tongue and from his hand. لا تؤذي الناس. وإذاء الناس يا إخوة مشكلة, يعني مظالم. These are injustices that you're going to be asked about in the day of judgment. And if you don't settle it in this world, guess what? You're going to pay back for it from your good deeds, from your capital, basically. An issue. But really what we want you to do is to get the other side, which is what? بذل الندى. That you're actually proactive. That you're helping out. You have a positive attitude about life. ولذلك يقولون حسن الخلق شيء هين. Having a good character is an easy thing. Look at this. وجه طليق. وجه طليق. You know when, سبحان الله, يعني a lot of us when we interact with non-Muslims we're very what? How you doing? It's very, and when we come to the masjid as if the teeth are awra. Assalamu alaikum. Alaikum salam. How are you, brother? Good. But look, when you even go to McDonald's, how you doing? Thank you. My wife sometimes notices this on me. You know, sometimes I would call her when I'm ordering something from McDonald's. So I tell the lady, thank you very much. You don't tell me that stuff. I serve you every time, dinner and lunch. And I don't know what is it, but I think we got to work on it. You know, I think we got to change that. We got to, you know, subhanAllah, لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا. شوف. Don't ever belittle a good thing. ولا أن تلقى أخاك بوجه طليق. That you meet. وتبسمك في وجه أخيك صدقة. ولذلك يقول لك إيه. Sometimes I quiz. السلام عليكم. How many حسنات did you make?
10.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. 20. That's from the hadith. We're not making that stuff up. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How many حسنات? 30. So السلام عليكم is 10. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله 20. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. طب how can you make it 40? How can you? With a smile. ما هو some of us do. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. لا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. ما هو أفشوا السلام بينكم, يعني make sometimes brothers tell you السلام عليكم brother. Where is the salam here? Where is the peace here? توعدني الرجل. I think he's threatening me. Where is the peace in that? حسن الخلق شيء هين, وجه طليق, وكلام لين. Lenient كلام. فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يحسن أخلاقنا. Very quickly, in 2 minutes, 2 Egyptian minutes. ما فضل حسن الخلق? What is the virtue of having a good character? I'm just going to share with you 2-3 hadith. Listen to this. إِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيَبْلُغُ بِحُسْنِ خُلُقِهِ دَرَجَةَ الصَّائِمِ الْقَائِمِ. Ya Allah.
A man, by the virtue of his good character, would attain the rank of someone who prays tahajjud every night and fasts every single day.
The scholars actually are puzzled by this hadith, ya ikhwa.
How?
حملوا الحديث على رجل يصوم كل يوم ويقوم كل ليلة ويؤذي الناس.
يعني they said one of the interpretation, يعني كلام العلماء في الحديث, يعني that imagine someone who prays every night and fast every day, but he still does what? He has a bad character. He's not well-mannered. What will happen to that person? He's going to lose what?
Al-Hasan al-Basri, just to get that meaning across to you quickly, Al-Hasan al-Basri, a famous predecessor, he learned that there is somebody in his town backbiting him. And he knew that this person loves ripe dates, rutab. So when his garden produced, he asked the person working for him, please go and collect the best ripe dates you can find in my garden. He packaged it really nice and he said, take it to him and tell him, thank you very much for your good deeds. Carry on backbiting me.
Yani, a message.
So imagine someone who does all type of hasanat. It's exactly like somebody, imagine I work for $100 a day and then I come at night, here is the $100. What would you say about this person?
Exactly.
But the one with a good character, he could do little, but because of his good character, he doesn't waste it. He keeps it.
The second hadith, ya ikhwa, hadith, أثقل شيء في ميزان العبد يوم القيامة حسن الخلق. The heaviest item in your scale in the day of judgment is to have a good character. والحديث الثالث, the third hadith, if you want to be with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, next to him in the day of judgment, you need his shafa'ah. أقربكم إلي مجلسا يوم القيامة أحاسنكم أخلاقا. أحاسنكم أخلاقا.
In the day of judgment, by the way, Anas, I just want to tell you that في سنن أبي داود, يا رسول الله اشفع لي يوم القيامة. Can you intercede for me on the day of judgment? أفعل. أين أجدك يا رسول الله? Where I'm going to find you amongst the masses? يعني, فimagine you're going to be next to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So when you're something short, you're in trouble, يشفع لك. A gift to the sisters, if any of them have this scenario, أم سلمة رضي الله عنها asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, ويا إخوة, لأن أم سلمة was married to أبو سلمة. She said, يا رسول الله, المرأة تكون يكون لها زوجان في الدنيا, فأيهما يكون زوجها في الجنة? A woman may end up with two husbands in the dunya. Who's going to be her husband in Jannah? You know what the Prophet ﷺ said to her? أحسنهم خلقا. The one who has the best of characters. One last one. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, أنا زعيم ببيت في ربض الجنة. I guarantee a house for a person in Jannah, in the outskirts of Jannah. For someone, لمن ترك المراء ولو كان محقا. for someone who would leave off arguing. Arguing, ya ikhwa, sometimes becomes personal. It's all about proving that I'm better than you, I know more than you. But when you see the conversation is taking that route, brother, no problem, don't worry about it. Okay, you're right, brother. It's becoming personal, it's not anymore about the subject of the argument. The Prophet guarantees that. وَأَنَا زَعِيمٌ بِبَيْتٍ فِي وَسَطِ الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ تَرَكَ الْكَذِبَ وَلَوْ كَانَ مَازِحًا. And I guarantee a house in the middle of Jannah for someone who leaves off lying, even if he's joking. A lot of us go, and in order to make the crowd laugh and have a good time, he ends up with what? Yeah. Brother, we're joking. Still a lie. Still a lie. وَأَنَا زَعِيمٌ بِبَيْتٍ فِي أَعْلَى الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ حَسُنَ خُلُقُهُ. And I guarantee a house in the top of Jannah, اللي هو الفردوس يعني, for someone who would have a good character. One last thing in one Egyptian minute. No, I'm just kidding. One last thing. What is the path to obtain good characters? How? How can you end up with a good character? إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَسَّمَ بَيْنَكُمْ أَخْلَاقَكُمْ كَمَا قَسَّمَ بَيْنَكُمْ أَرْزَاقَكُمْ. شوف الحديث. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like He given you rizq, He given you characters. That means who should you ask to have a good character? عليك باللجوء إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى. وده في دعاء الاستفتاح ولا لأ؟ One of the supplications that we make when we open the salah after the takbirat al-ihram, Allahumma ahdini li ahsan al-akhlaq. Oh Allah, guide me to the best of characters. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي لِأَحْسَنِهَا إِلَّا أَنْتِ. So دعاء. يعني الحديث الثاني حقيقة في سنده كلام, اللي هو إيه, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he would look at the mirror, he would say, اللهم كما أحسنت خلقي, لا كما أحسنت خلقي أحسن خلقي. Oh Allah, like you made me look good, make my character also look good. فعليك باللجوء إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى والدعاء أنه يحسن أخلاقك. The circle, يا إخوة, you're in, your company. يا إخوة, العرب يقولون الصاحب ساحب. سبحان الله. الصاحب ساحب. That your companion will drag you. والمرء على دين خليل. If you're hanging around people who use profanity, people who lie, that's the type that you're going to end up with, you know. But يعني الناس, الرجل الدين, that's the type that you want to have. Learn سيرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم. بالله عليك, من زكى؟ رب العالمين يقول عن نبيك, you have the best of characters. The best of characters. وهذا وصف النبي على فكرة في التوراة. The description of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the Torah is about his character. There is a book, يا إخوة, called the book of Isaiah. وأثر عطاء ابن يسار في صحيح البخاري. أيزيه, أثر عطاء ابن يسار, عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص was يعني he got really very interested towards the end of his life with reading the Torah and the Gospel. فعطاء ابن يسار said to him, يعني he asked him, can you please tell us what is the description of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the Torah. If there is a description in the Torah, imagine this. Look at the description of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the Torah. الذين يتبعون الرسول النبي الأمية. Those who follow الرسول, the prophet, the illiterate. الذي يجدونه مكتوبا عندهم في التوراة. There is a description for the prophet. Look at the description. يا أيها as if I'm look at, يا أيها النبي إنا أرسلناك شاهدا ومبشرا ونذيرا. ده في التوراة. وحرزا للأمين سميتك المتوكل أنت عبدي ورسولي لست بفظ ولا غليظ ولا صخاب بالأسواق لا تجزي بالسيئة السيئة ولكن تعفو وتصفح. هذا وصف نبينا في التوراة بالخلق بأخلاقه. فعندك سيرة to be taught. That you know, imagine, يا إخوة, someone comes like this, holding the leader of the ummah. أعطني من مال الله ليس بمالك ولا مال أبيك. يعني the companions say the face of the prophet got in red. Give me from the wealth of Allah. It's not your wealth nor the wealth of your father. He let go of him. Please give him. Imagine somebody, a lot of the brothers told me that story that happened in Rashid, and I hope I don't get trouble in sharing that story. That's some brother came to accept Islam, but he ended up parking the car in a wrong way, something like that. So one of the brothers here, they told me this happened here. I don't know. Wallahi, I don't know who, and I'm not going to tell you who told me. So one of the brothers came and said, who's parking in there is blocking my way? I said, this brother reverted, he's about to accept. No, we don't want him. If he's going to be like, we don't want him to be like, we don't want him to accept Islam like this. If he's going to be like, that's not the type that we want. But nice. Imagine a Bedouin, a person walks into the masjid and he urinates. We're not talking about parking the car. Imagine this. The companions did what to him? You know the hadith, right? The story was, I'm sure you heard it before. The companions what? And pushed him. What are you doing? لا تزرمو. لا تزرمو. Let him finish. Let him finish. شوف, look at the kindness. To the man comes and he approaches him out al sahihay kharij al sahihayn yani, and he makes this dua, Allahumma arhamni wa muhammada wa la tarham ma'ana ahad. Shuf, oh Allah, have mercy on me and Muhammad alone and no one else. Rasul said, la, this one is a little much. Qala laqad hajjarta wasi'a. Allah says, wa rahmati wasi'at kull shay, you just wanna be, this is a lot. والقصة المشهورة إخوة بتاعت معاذ بن جبل, just to show you the character, the سيرة. عندك سيرة, wealth of characters. ولقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة, example. معاذ بن جبل belongs to a tribe called Bani سلمة. Bani Salama used to live far away from Al-Masjid Al-Nabawi. For they said, Ya Rasulullah, we want to build a masjid for us, يعني. Because us going back and forth five times a day is. For Rasulullah Sallam let them do it. But they said, but we must have Mu'adh to lead us in Salah. فمعاذ said, والله ما أترك الصلاة خلف رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, by Allah, I will not leave Salah behind the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Mu'adh, Ya Mu'adh, salli khalfi al-isha, pray behind me isha, Bani Salama delay the isha, so he can come and lead you. And we use this hadith, ya ikhwa, always as an evidence that the imam and the imamed intention can mismatch. And some of the brothers under the impression that we must have the intention. Yani, la, an imam can have an intention and the imam. The salah, the isha that Mu'adh is praying, is the mandatory isha or the voluntary isha? Because he prayed isha already behind the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But what about the imam behind him, those who are praying behind him? They are praying the mandatory or the voluntary? There is a mismatch. Now you praying behind the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, your imaniyat what? And imagine we hear some of the brothers reciting, like, mashallah, imagine the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recitation. Iman Mu'adh is a little bit what? So one day he came and he led the salah. And he started al-Baqarah and he kept going. Surah al-Baqarah. So a Bedouin praying behind him, he's standing and he's going on. You know al-Baqarah is what? And Mu'adh is going. He left the salah. He went to the side, prayed Isha by himself and he went home. When Mu'adh learned, قال هو منافق خرجت منه يعني رضي الله عنه. He's a hypocrite. The Bedouin got very upset. And he went to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم complaining Mu'adh. And that's where the famous statement is what? أفتان. But sometimes the brothers use it with an imam who recites four verses, five verses. You read four verses, five verses. Ya Sheikh, أفتان أنت يا Sheikh. البقرة كان يقرأ بالبقرة. يعني ف when the Bedouin approached the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, يعني you can tell he says, يا رسول الله, O Messenger of Allah, إني لا أفهم دندنتك ولا دندنة معاذ. شوف ما هو البدو يا إخوة, البدو يعني البدو ما عندهمش الإيه, they are not what, they are not political. البدوي ما عندوش لف ودوران, هي دي يعني يحكي لنا شيوخنا أن I'll go back to the story. أمير من الأمراء, أمير wanted to go and do hunting. So he went out to the desert and he got a deer. So, you know, he's hunting and his servants cooked for him a whole sheep. A whole sheep on rice, huge, and they brought it to him to eat. So he looked at the food and he said, I'm going to eat this by myself. It's too much. Please go and find me somebody to share the food with me. Fahi, in the desert, he's going to find what? A Bedouin. Fal Badawi came, the Bedouin came, and he saw roasted sheep, yani, rice. فالأمير is looking at him and saying, ما لك منكب عليها كأن أمه نطحتك. Why are you doing this to the sheep as if the mother of the sheep knocked you down? شوف look what the Bedouin said to the Amir. وما لك مشفق عليها كأن أمه أرضعتك. And why are you feeling compassionate for the sheep as if the mother of the sheep breastfed you? ما عندوش. The Bedouin is what? إني لا أفهم دندنتك ولا دندنة معاذ. But look the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. ما تقول في صلاتك? What do you say in your salah? قال أسأل الله الجنة وأستعيد به من النار. وأستعيد به من النار. I seek refuge with Allah from hell and I ask him for Jannah. What did the Prophet say to him? حولها ندند. So he complained about Mu'adh. Here is Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gets Mu'adh. Don't do this. من صلى بالناس فليخفف ففيهم الضعيف وذي الحاجة. Just to show you when the Bedouin learned about Mu'adh's statement, he said to the Prophet ﷺ, one day Mu'adh will know that I'm not a hypocrite. Subhanallah, ikhwa, this Bedouin was killed in one of the battles. Shaheed. Ma huwa, they are straightforward, but يعني, when they are truthful, they are truthful. Fasubhanallah, Mu'adh right away, he said, I mistaken him. I was wrong when I made that statement. يعني, it was wrong for me to make that statement. فسيرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. You have a wealth of knowledge to obtain regarding الأخلاق, the good company, the دعاء, and so forth, inshallah. يعني, I don't want to abuse you more. That's enough. I mean, I got into a stage, by the way, I can talk until Fajr. I want to tell you that. But inshallah, يعني, maybe we'll allow question and answer session, inshallah. If we have any questions and answers, but جزاكم الله خيرا يعني for attending and listening, inshallah. Do we have any questions? Say. Huh? لا لا open inshallah. نعم.
يعني فيها يعني ثلاث مذاهب يعني
نعم في بلد يعني وممكن يعني في هذا السؤال يعني ماذا يعني نعم نعم a very good question يا إخوة. I think it's very beneficial especially for Muslims who live in the West. America and Canada and all these places are a pool for multiple school of thoughts. The brothers who come from Pakistan, India, they are normally followers of the school of thought of Imam Abi Hanifa rahimahullah. The brothers who come from West Africa, المنطقة المغرب, they are more with Imam Malik rahimahullah. Egypt, Syria, Lebanon, more of الشافعي rahimahullah. والحنابلة في الجزيرة, the Arabian Peninsula. And we come to America. And now comes in the conflict, the what should we do with this regard? I think if you understand why the imams differed, you will find the solution right there. We need to understand that all these imams existed the first 300 years. The hadith was not available to all of them. So when somebody would ask them a question, he would give his verdict, ruling, yani, based on what he has available of evidence. Because al-hadith was in Medina. For it to travel was not there. Add to this, the sun'at al-hadith, اللي هو the authentication and the weakening of the hadith was not matured yet. So some of them actually would rule based on a weak hadith, but he doesn't know. All these imams, ya ikhwa, they made that statement. Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, for example, he said, إِذَا صَحَّ الْحَدِيثُ فَهُوَ مَذْهَبِي. If I ruled over a matter
and you found an authentic hadith that contradicts my ruling, then the hadith overrides my madhhab. وقال لأبي يوسف, one of his students, لا يحق لك أن تفتي برأيي من غير أن تعرف دليلي. You cannot pass on my ruling without knowing the evidence I used to establish that ruling. Because maybe that evidence is weak. Or maybe that evidence was abrogated. Or maybe that evidence was particular case, was khas, was عام. الشافعي رحمه الله إذا خالف رأيي قول رسول الله فرموا برأيي عرض الحائط. ما هو if you really understand these imams and their righteousness and piety and their care, all of them were trying to bring us closer to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. If my opinion contradicts the opinion of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, throw my opinion out of the window. Malik said, رحمه الله, كل يؤخذ منه ويرد إلا صاحب هذا القبر. سنة يعني. لأن مالك كان في المدينة. He can say no to anybody, including me. The only one you cannot say no to is the one who is buried right here in reference to his sunnah. Who's left? Ahmed. قال لا تأخذ مني ولا من سفيان, سفيان بن عيينة, ولا من إسحاق بن راهوي, ولا سفيان الثوري, ولكن خذ من المنبع. Take from the source. Don't take from me. Don't take from these. Take from the source. فالأصل, الأصل, you're supposed to follow the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Whoever brings you closer to the Prophet, this is the one you follow. وذلك يقول لك إيه؟ دور مع الدليل. Circle around the evidence. Whoever provides the evidence, that's the one you follow. But let's be practical. A lot of the brothers don't have the ability to check the evidence. في ناس ما ينفع معهم غير التقليد, العوام, layman, ما عنده فهم للنصوص. ما هو it takes also a student of knowledge to read the hadith and understand مورد الحديث. The يعني زي سبب النزول, مورد زي السبب كده, يعني why the hadith was cited. ف he's gonna follow a certain imam. خلاص, he can't force them. He cannot. And you have to be tolerant. And if you see them doing something in the masjid, as long as it's not a bid'ah, as long as it has a place in the sunnah, don't condemn this. Don't. Don't. Because there is brotherhood. And يعني I tell you an ideal example. And يعني we see this in the East Coast more. East Coast is crazy, in Egypt, in America. You stand in the salah, you're leading the salah, and by all of a sudden you hear with the feet. And you look like, what? You know the إخوة الأحناف, يعني ما عندهمش موضوع الإيه, يعني they don't إيه, close the gaps much, يعني تربوا على هذا. الناس التانية اللي هو إيه بقى, so now the brother إيه, this brother is standing and there is a distance in between. So he brings his feet closer to him. Then he goes away. Then this one goes away. يا أخي الحديث معروف. في شيطان really there. I understand. But you standing and you brought your feet next to him. He did like this. Should you do it again? لا. لا. Let go. خلاص. Maybe after the salah educate him. So he does like this again. What's wrong with this? This is in salah. In salah. What we should do is educate, learn, and so forth. الأصل يا إخوة, and it really should be the imam's job to
choose especially the areas or the issues where there is congregation and so forth, inshallah. But at the end of the day, we follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You strive. ولذلك كل من جاءه علم أن هذا العمل كان يعمله رسول الله يجب عليه أن يعمله لو هو فاهم يعني للموضوع. الله المستعان يعني. بارك الله فيكم يا إخوة، جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم. اتفضل. Yes. إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا. فجر comes at 10 o'clock. هذا يعني هذه الصلاة. There is a view of the jurist that a salah which is prayed out of its time intentionally is not accepted. So you need to talk to him about this, that he has to pray on time. جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، أستغفرك وأتوب إليك، والحمد لله رب العالمين. بكرة بقى إن شاء الله. جزاك الله خير. بارك الله. I'm here فجر ظهر and then after that إن شاء الله to the airport إن شاء الله. جزاكم الله خيرا والله for your hospitality and your kind treatment. I enjoyed my visit. جزاكم الله خير.
الله يسلمك. في محادثة ولا؟
إن شاء الله.
طيب يا شيخ، شو الاسم الكريم احنا
والله؟ كريم ابو زيد.
كريم ابو زيد. فش طيب يا شيخ.
الله يعزك يا شيخ.
اتمنى نراك يعني انت قاعد في دنبر في امريكا ان شاء الله.
ان شاء الله.
ان شاء الله سيدي. طيب وربنا يحفظك ويعافيك.
جزاك الله خير.
I'm sorry I say his 2 minutes became 25.
I know. That's why I said Egyptian minutes. يعني طيب بركات. جزاك الله خير. How are you؟ سي وش الحمد لله. كيف حالك؟ ما شاء الله كيف صحة حبيبي؟ يحفظك يا رب. سلام بركاته فيكم. بارك الله فيك. الله يعزك. الله يبارك. سلام بركاته. الله يعزك. السلام عليكم. ما شاء الله. How you doing? Inshallah. How's it going?
In future talks, you could say the Bedouins are very bad drivers.
The what?
The Bedouins. Very
the Bedouins.
Bad.
Yeah. سلام بركاته. جزاك الله خير. بارك الله فيك.
لا تتم السؤال. يعني وإذا كان الإمام هو مثلاً خاد بي يعني مثلاً بأمر يعني في يعني مثلاً كما قلت لك يعني ثلاث مذاهب يقولون نعم هو خادم وكان مذهب هل تتبع يعني بدون
لا أمشي مع الجمهور. أمشي مع الجمهور.
لا هو اختار يعني مش من الجمهور يعني بدون
يعني يصحح بس على جنب مش أمام الناس يعني يصحح
إلا كان هاسه يعني
ربنا ربنا يهدينا ربنا يهدينا
يعني يدخل لي يعني هذا
سلطة بركات. الله يعزك. الله يبارك لك.
السؤال عكس معليش. هلا الإنسان اللي بيصلي وبصوم وكل شيء بيعمل الأمور اللي على العبادات يعني ولكن خلقه سيء، هل معناه أنه في خلل في العبادة بيعملها؟
نعم بالتأكيد.
نعم بارك الله.
ما هو وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر. كثير من الناس يقول لك طب أنا بصلي. لا أقم الصلاة كما أقامها النبي.
يعني الصلاة صحيحة تنهى عن الفحشاء.
يعني الصلاة.
أما فيها نقص معناته عنده نقص بالله.
نعم أحسنت.
بارك الله فيك. كنت حابب أسألك هذا السؤال أمام الناس.
قدر الله ما شاء الله. جزاكم الله خير. بارك الله فيك.
شيخ هذه أمانة مش.
جزاك الله خير. بارك الله فيك. جزاك الله خير. Did you copy it?
Yeah.
Can you please send it to me?
I can send you by number or by Bluetooth. It's like long the. This feed is long.
Maybe so where are you going to do it?
Maybe by if you have a USB I can say.
Can you bring it tomorrow?
Yeah.
Okay. Sure. Are you going to be here for Fajr?
Yeah, I'll try. Yeah.
Okay. Did you record all of it?
Yeah, I record everything, but sometimes when it goes like a 45 minute cards.
Okay, that's fine. Yeah. We can fix it. Everything. Please, if you can.
Inshallah.
So at Fajr, I'll take it. I'll bring a USB.
Yeah.
Okay. جزاك الله خير. بارك الله فيك. جزاك الله خير. بارك الله فيك. جزاك الله خير. أحسن الله إليك. جزاك الله. سعطة بركاته. جزاك الله خير. بارك الله فيك. أحسن الله إليك. مرة. أيوه. سعطة بركاته. أشهد كيف حالك؟ كيف صحتك؟ إن شاء الله. يلا بينا.
بعدنا بكرة.
إن شاء الله بقى مهير تمر إن شاء الله.
نقصر. نقصر أنا وياك.
أيوه.
يلا محمد.
Is
جزاك الله خير مره. جزاك الله خير.
شرفنا معرفنا.
الله يعينك.
إن شاء الله بكرة.
كيف فرنسي عارف؟ أنا عارف.
Yeah, رفيق زوجي قلت لك اللي went to see some sheikh today and no cross in his.
شيخ حمدي.
Maybe yeah. شيخ حمدي for the blind fed.
حكاني بشيخ حمدي حاضر.
Yes yes.
أيوة شيخ حمدي. خلاص ركبي.
خير الله رح.
الحمد لله. الحمد لله. كيف حالك؟
إن شاء الله. إن شاء الله. My brother soon إن شاء الله.
نعم إن شاء الله. It'll be okay. Denver is a good place.
Yeah الحمد لله. الحمد لله. الحمد لله. He met Akil. He met the guy you told him to.
Ayman.
الحمد لله.
إن شاء الله. Come visit in April too.
إن شاء الله. We'll see you إن شاء الله. إن شاء الله. خلاص ركبي. الحمد لله.
Question.
علم الرجال اللي هو الرجال الحديث.
So basically in the chain.
A chain. Yeah. You need to know who's in the chain. And where did they live and what kind of biography they had, their background and everything. هذا هو علم الرجال.
Okay.
وده مهم للي بيخرج. This is very important for the one who does the تخريج. You know the تخريج is. So basically he gets a hadith and he looks at the chain.
Okay.
Yes, and then he looks, he takes this man out. What is this man? Who talked about him? Al-Dhahabi, for example. And then he goes and he check it down and see how they labeled him. Yes. جزاك الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته يا شيخنا.
كيف حالك؟ الله يبارك لك. الله يجزاك رب العالمين. كيف حالك؟
كريم أبو زيد الله يبارك لك.
بفضل الله عمر عبد
الله. كيف حالك؟ كيف حالك شيخنا؟ الله يهديك وعلي شانك. كيف حالك؟
أحبك الله.
أحبك الذي يحب الله. جزاك الله خير.
الله طيب الله يجزاك السلام
ويجزاك العافية. أفعل أفعل.
ما تعرف حدا اسمه أحمد عبد الله.
أحمد عبد
الله.
أيوه سمعت ليش شيكار وحاجة زي كده
شيكار
ايوه خبر ما شاء الله ما شاء الله
هو ذكرك امامنا
الله يبارك لك
ما كل من نشوفه
الله يبارك لك ربنا
يحفظك
اللهم لك الحمد اللهم لك الحمد
واذا انت رايت هناك تسلم
افعل افعل انا راح شيكار ان شاء الله في شهر 2 الله يعني اللهم بارك لنا في أرزاقنا بس عليك بالتوكل
اوه
السلام عليكم كيف حالك الحمد لله السلام عليكم وبركاته السلام عليكم سلام اهلا حبيبي
وعليكم السلام ورحمه الله وبركاته
الموضوع حلو لله
قال ان الحظ كنا محتاجين
والله
ما بلغ
طويله
ربنا يسر
ما شاء الله تقريبا ساعة ونصف.